Ooh, stuff, stuff. Somebody sent something to Toughner Toys. Ooh, ooh. Ooh, boy, oh boy, oh boy. Ooh. Ooh, look at what they sent me to review. Look at this. Ooh, E. Ooh, ah, yes, 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 yes. Oh, wow, come on, baby. Go easy on me, please.
This dream for more than a decade now.
Lewis, this guy's gonna be your new partner.
Glad to know you, Murphy.
All Detroit has a cancer. Cancer is crime.
Three dead police officers, one critically injured.
Let's prep you for Central Line. Ass trousers out.
Get the clothes off.
Get the best of both worlds. The fastest reflexes modern technology has to offer, onboard computer-assisted memory, and a lifetime of on-the-street law enforcement.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen, toy enthusiasts and those new to Toughner Toys LLC. I'm your host, Uncle Nerd, and welcome to another exciting episode of Busted Open. Busting it open since 2007, and today we'll be reviewing Hagane Works, Diecast Robocop, Hagane Works. No, I think it's Hagane Works, that's right. I thought that was an A right there, but Hagane Works, Robocop action figure, goods by Good Smile Company. So, I mean, like, it's a bunch of people going on here making this action figure, which I think is awesome. And I love reviewing import action figures. No, I don't just deal in Marvel Legends, Joes, and I collect action figures. And this right here was brought to me by my wonderful friend, or lent to me by my wonderful friend, Count Kenny, and co-host on the show. And definitely check out Toughner Toys TNT Photon HQ, powered by Toughner Toys. And yeah, Robocop is one of my favorite action figures, so this right here was an absolute blessing for him to lend to me so that I could review it. I've been a little bit busy because my cat died and stuff like that. I was adjusting, you know, getting my mind together, because I don't like doing these videos when I'm sad. I like doing them when I'm really upbeat and I'm really in a good mood. And today I am in an awesome mood. You know what I'm saying? I got the spirit of Saki running through me. To me, he's still running around here, so on and so forth. So yeah, Kenny let me hold this action figure so that I could review it. He says he likes my reviews, and I'm very honored that he does. I took that as an ultimate honor. So Robocop is a film that was released in 1987 by wonderful, that was directed by the wonderful Paul Verhoeven, and written by Paul Verhoeven. He's also done Total Recall, Starship Troopers. All of those movies I've absolutely loved. You know, they're just wonderful. RoboCop was essentially a futuristic Frankenstein story in the veil of like a dystopian future. I think it was Old Detroit, yeah. And I've always been a RoboCop fan. When it first came out, I was at the time I was collecting Silverhawks action figures. I was a little kid, and I thought that they were trying to mimic, because you know when it comes to movies, they go on trends and stuff. And I thought they were trying to mimic the cyborg trend that was with Silverhawks. I watched this movie and I absolutely fell in love. My mother didn't want me to watch it at first because it was ultra violent, but then she was just like, you know what, she wouldn't have got me the tape and everything like that. No, actually I went to go see it against her will. And then she eventually got me the tape and stuff like that. And from there, I became a RoboCop fan. Enough about me. Here we go right here into this box. It is a beautiful, solid box. You have warnings over here and all of the, you know, a lot of stuff in different languages right here. But you have the choking hazard that's listed right here. Other languages, so on and so forth. It's letting you know to be careful. It's not for three-year-olds. Small parts, not for children under 3 years old. You got the beautiful product image of RoboCop on the top by Hagane Works. On the back, you have other images of the product right here, looking wonderful, and this looks great. Man, this looks absolutely amazing. I love RoboCop. This looks absolutely amazing. Let me straighten it out for you guys. And yeah, you know, you got the product, different accessories that are in the box that let you know. Because most import action figures, they usually don't give you a window box. You'd usually have to open the box, and you'll see inside what's going on. Right here, you got the RoboCop logo. As you can see right there, it's in a nice solid cardboard box, but a shiny cardboard box. You have the nice image of RoboCop right here, his targeting system going on with looks like a mesh in the background right there. And this, yeah, you got the Hagane Works RoboCop logo down there and the Good Smile Company. And I think that's all for the box. So let's back this up, bust open the package and see if this guy is worth the scratch. Okay, and we are back, and man, oh man, this action figure came packed with a ton of accessories. Some things I took out so that you can see, but I mean, like, I will review all of the accessories that were included right here. Let's bring this back a little bit. And this right here is just a little bit. And of course it comes with instructions right here, but there's not much you need to know. I mean, like, it's most of these parts just snap on and snap off, or they, like in the chest right here, it's a magnetized, it magnetizes right here so you can change the chest plates. But it comes with multiple accessories right there. And these are all the accessories that are included right here. And it's over 16 pieces going on here with a base. And you can see right here how you can change the heads and the faces and everything like that. Yeah, and you can also store them away inside of the base right here so that you won't lose things, which I think is awesome. And it comes with a stand as well. So as always, instead of the figure, I like to go into the accessories. Let me know if you want me to do it the other way around from thus forth, but I like going into the accessories and stuff like that. So let's bring this a little bit closer. And here we have the mouthpiece. It comes with different mouthpieces of RoboCop right here, as you can see. You can easily put these on. There's another mouthpiece right here of RoboCop. I've always loved RoboCop's lips. Sounds crazy, right? I've always loved the look of his lips and stuff. Here it comes, an action figure stand piece right here so that you can pretty much like put him in poses. You know, you loosen up the screws right here, but this one is pretty stiff. This is a good action figure stand that they give you right here, or a post that they give you to stick into the base. Right here, that looks absolutely amazing. Looks amazing. Then you have the Auto 9, and I've already put the Auto 9 RoboCop signature gun. I put it in his hand, and as you can see, I'm going to show you guys that you can switch out different hands, so on and so forth. You also got a damage version of the chest plate with a magnet in the back right here, where you can literally just pull this piece off and put the magnet piece on, and it comes with great detail. You got the battle damage right here, the nice looking detail of RoboCop's chest plate right there and everything. You got the little rivets, sockets and stuff like that. Nice line work on it right there. Nice vent on the side, looking good. You have the Cobra assault weapon, which is very, very big right here. Very big. This is a big, I mean, it's taller than the figure, which it should be. And this figure is ranging around about, I would like say like 7 to 8 inches. Not that much detail, done in a nice shiny plastic, but I mean, it's the Cobra assault weapon. How much detail you need on it? This is exactly how it looked in the movie. It was a big giant cannon that they used to, that the criminals was running around with. Although, see, Dick Jones, no, what was his name? Clarence Boddicker and his crew, Emil Clarence Boddicker. That movie, the first one, will always be a milestone in sci-fi pop culture. I mean, like, Clarence Boddicker, to me, was the best criminal ever. He was amazing. Loved him. Loved him. Then you have a beautiful headpiece right here, which you can switch out as you saw in the instructions. You can switch this headpiece out right here. Nice battle damage too right there. If you can see, kind of like, you know, reminiscent of the RoboCop movie when they were attacking him after he fought Ed 209. Some people got on me on my last video because I called him ED209, or me myself, I always called him ED209. It was like, oh, you're not a real fan if you call him ED209. I said, well, sometimes he was called ED209 or Ed209. And I showed you the Auto 9 right here. Then you have also, let me bring this back a little bit for you guys. You also have some accessories going on right here. I didn't want to pull all of these out as not and make sure I didn't lose them or anything like that. But you got a lot of accessories right here. Different hands right here. As you can see, you have the, let me make sure I get this right. You have the interface hand right here. Remember when he was checking all the criminal records with Clarence Boddicker and his crew? It was like assault, murder, assault. You know, can't say that word on YouTube, but you know, he was doing, Clarence Boddicker was a bad boy, man. He was a bad boy. And if you haven't seen the first RoboCop movie, you can pretty much catch it on any streaming service. I think Amazon has it up there. The first RoboCop movie, the first two were the best in my opinion. The rest, I don't know. You know, and I mean, you know, you got the tactical knuckles on the hands as with as in the movie. Let me bring this closer so you get some more light and see. And yeah, I mean, you know, there you go. This is his interface hand right there when he went in interface with the city computer. You got more trigger hands over here, and then you got some open hands, as you can see. You got some open hands right there, and you got another trigger hand for his left hand if you want to switch it over. Now, I think those are all of the accessories. Hopefully I've covered all of them. Now we are going to go into this beautiful, and I mean beautiful, figure, because this right here, this surprised me. This totally surprised me. Now here we go with this beautiful figure right here. And Hagane Works did, I hope I'm pronouncing that correctly, but Hagane Works did a fantastic job on this. And I took the glove, the other glove off, so that I can get some cold touch going on this. Because this thing, I'm gonna reveal something to you. This is die cast metal. Cold. This is all, everywhere you see me touch, die cast. There's die cast metal. This is a heavy figure. Even the joints feel like make this figure, it's equivalent to, I would say, like a, in weight, this has to be around about close to three or four pounds. It's that heavy. It's a solid figure. Absolutely beautiful, nice side profile, everything. Loving the feet on here. You can see the detail along the legs and everything like that. I didn't think I was gonna like this figure because, again, inside of the box, when I first pulled them out, I was like, eh. But this figure is a beauty to behold. And as you can see, there is detail. There's detail all along the back right here. And this right, yeah, this is die-cast metal on the back. And the chest piece, as I said before, if you want to, you can replace it and put in the other one. And again, this chest piece is die-cast metal. So you're literally getting a figure that's made of die-cast metal. Now the price point for this may have gone up, you know? Feet are die-cast. I'm just doing a cold touch right here. Cold touch is what you do to figure out if you got die-cast metal or plastic right here. This is plastic. This is die-cast. Die-cast. All of this right here is die-cast. Plastic in the middle right here. And yes, you can pull this off because you, as I showed you before, you can switch these faces out right here, which I'm not going to do because I don't want to go too much into that. But I mean, like, you can pull this off so that you can get different head, different scenes from RoboCop. Beautiful range of motion going on with the neck and head. You can actually imitate some of the movement that he did in the RoboCop movie, and it fits right back on very snug. You got the nice little clasp on the top right here on his shoulders, or pretty much near his traps. This looks good. Look at the nice detail in the arm right there. Again, I'm touching all of this. It's like diecast on any. It seems like anywhere they could put diecast metal, they did. They did. This is a heavy figure, a very heavy figure. What else we got going on here? This is just a nice figure, man. Very nice. Look at the detail in the back of his head right there, and his neck and everything like that. You got the OCP label up here. If you look real good, you see the OCP inscription on his skull or his helmet. Nice detail in the arm, so on and so forth. The joints are, well, with RoboCop, you can actually do that because you are, you know, it's RoboCop, so you can get the joint thing going on and it doesn't look too bad. I think they should have bulked them up on his arms a little bit, but I still like this figure. It is beautiful. Nice detail in the mid area. It's done in a solid plastic. They did some good detailing, and yeah, it's done in a silver gray gunmetal paint. It's like a shiny gunmetal, like gunmetal paint. You got the pistons on the back of his legs right here, the nice calf vents and everything as he had in the movie. The feet are nice and big too, but you don't have, yes, you do have toe pivoting too. Look at that. You got toe pivoting going on. This figure is a beauty. It's on a ball joint. If I can see, it looks like it's on a ball joint at the leg. So this is a beautiful, beautiful piece right here. You got OCP along the leg right there. This is movie accurate. Down to the T. This is absolutely beautiful. Now his face I absolutely love because it has the nice soft look that he had when he first appeared in the first RoboCop film. And I'm going to change this plate back right here. And again, these plates come on and off very easily. It's held on by a magnet, as you can see. Hold on. He has beautiful hinged ball joints over here, if you can see real good. And I mean, they even put a little bit of detail in here. Now it's flat within there, flat plastic, flat shiny plastic. Has nice range of motion in the waist and in the torso area right here. You can get a nice ab crunch going on. Yeah, and look, it actually looks like it's riveted right here. And I mean, that's what I like about this. This has like very realistic detail, movement, and articulation on this action figure, represented, you know, to the source material, rather, the movie, rather. And again, the first movie was amazing to me. You got the nice RoboCop butt going on right there. I mean, you know, that on the side profile, because you know they always gave him the big booty with the nice thighs and everything like that, and the big calves and everything. But these pistons back here are absolutely amazing. And yes, they do work properly. As you can see, you got some nice piston work going on right there. Oh man, this figure is absolutely beautiful. There are no thigh twists or anything like that, but you got some twists in the knee right here that pretty much supplement as twists for his feet, or towards like where usually they would be in the calf. But this figure is amazing. It is beautiful. This is a beautiful piece right here. Definitely a beautiful piece. The detail and articulation I could go on with for days. I love the nice little sculpted vents that they have right here, how they have the chest plate that pretty much goes over the, you know, the cylinder looking midsection right here. You can see like they've done great sculpting and detail of the reminiscent of RoboCop right in there. Long his arms, his forearms and everything like that. You got the authentic rubber glove, but like I like the rubber glove or plastic glove look that RoboCop always had. Yet with the detail, they didn't miss a beat with this. This looks absolutely amazing. And yes, it wouldn't be the RoboCop figure if you were not able to what? Open up the leg and do the shriek, shriek. And yes, you can open up the leg. I already put an Auto 9 in here. It came with two Auto 9s. I put one in here, as you can see, and it fits very snug. You can open it up and close it back. See? Nice and snug. And it doesn't feel like it's going to break either. Now, you can switch out hands as well. And I told you, I put the Auto 9 hand, the Auto 9 in this hand already, so we wouldn't have to go through all of that. And switching out hands are very easy, as you can see. Drop the gun, you are under arrest. Nice range of motion. Got a nice twist at the elbow, as you can see. And again, most of this stuff, like most Asian figures or most, you know, figures from Japan or Asia, whatever the case may be, you can like pull some of these parts, you know, take some, sometimes you can take them apart, pull things out, so on and so forth. But this figure is beautiful engineering and craftsmanship. This is a beautiful, beautiful. Got nice range of motion in the leg right there. Got nice range of motion right there. Same thing on this, on each side. You can get some, wow. You can actually get like a knee pull. Look at this. Look at this. This is nice, especially for a RoboCop figure. This blows NECA up. Now, as far as, how can I say? We're gonna do a comparison at the end, but this right here, this totally blows the NECA ones away, because I do have the NECA ones, and this is absolutely amazing. You got beautiful, as you can see, you got nice range of motion in the head. You can go up, down, get a nice pivot going and everything like that. You can twist his head left and right. Again, Hagane works. You did a great job, and I love reviewing import figures and stuff. Got some nice hinge work going on over here in the shoulders. Again, I showed you the twist and maneuverability that you have in the torso and waist. It's at least like three sections that you can move this figure around in, which makes it beautiful. Nice movement within the legs and hips. You're not only going to be able to maneuver it, or how can I say, give it a leg split, but so far, because you know of the construction or the engineering of the figure right there. But this is gorgeous. This is absolutely beautiful. Wow, look at that hinge right there. Gives it, and look, you can see like there's a pin right there. Like they did some great, great work, and it doesn't feel like it's gonna fall apart. I don't feel like I gotta touch this with kid gloves or anything like that. This is a nice piece, a heavy piece too. Like you could throw this at somebody and hurt someone. That's how solid and heavy it is. And most of the die cast is in the chest, legs, you know, the lower legs and the shins, along the chest, along the back, some parts of the head, you know, some parts of the arms, because like I feel a little bit of cold touch right here and right here. So I mean, like, this is a beautiful figure. And again, I had to take the gloves off. When I take the gloves off, you know it's about to go down. It's about to go down, because we got to do that when we in the lab. We got to take off, we got to keep the gloves on them when we in the lab. But if I take it off, that means I want to touch the product. I want to touch the product myself. Yeah, but man, this is a beautiful figure. The detail on this is absolutely amazing. Can you bend him? He has a nice, well, you, it's RoboCop. You shouldn't be doing a whole bunch of ab crunching or whatever the case may be, but you can put him in a ton of poses that you weren't able to with other figures, you know? And you also have the, as you can see, you can give him the, hold on, the Cobra right here. The Cobra Assault. And again, you can put it in both hands. You can get some two-hand action going if you want. But you know RoboCop's strong, so he can carry this and handle this like it's nothing. Drop the gun, you are under arrest. So yeah, look, you can get that nice two-hand action going. Boom, boom. Man, this is a beauty. And again, this is done by Hagane Works. I don't know if it's still available. I will check and see, but this is a beauty right here, man. And again, it's done in a nice metallic shiny paint, but kind of like a gunmetal as well. And again, like the plastic that you see, the black plastic is done in a shiny plastic. None of the construction on this feels flimsy. I don't feel as though this thing is going to come apart. I feel as though it has a, it's a figure with longevity as well. But that face sculpt, absolutely love it. And again, as I showed you before, you can switch out different faces and stuff like that, as you can see. Hopefully you guys can see this. Let me put this over here because it's still focused on. You can switch out different face right there, and you can get some nice stuff going on right there. And you got his stressing face when he was being attacked and the police turned on him and everything like that, as I showed you before. And yes, he does come with two different, what do you call them? Two different Auto 9 pistols. This is the long one, and a shorter one you can put inside of his leg right there, so you can get that look going on and everything. But as a whole, this figure is a beautiful. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to take some pictures, and I will be right back with you guys. Okay, we're going to do a little comparison and do some sizes as well. But I think I covered everything in his articulation, because I showed you his feet and ankles. You got nice ankle rockers going on, and I showed you the toe pivot that's on both sides right there. So yeah, they did a great job with this figure. Great job. So give me a second. Be right back, guys, okay? So, I mean, as a whole, this figure is absolutely amazing. I love it. I think it's beautiful. And, I mean, this guy is coming in at about, let's see. Hagane Works Robocop figure is coming in at about 7 inches. 7 inches, yeah. coming in about 7 inches. And it's just a beautiful, it's a complete masterpiece. And again, inside the package, when I first pulled it out, I was like, eh. But then when I posed them and I started moving them around and I started looking at them, I was like, okay, this is not to be played with. Now, as I told you, I was going to do a comparison with some of my other RoboCop figures. Here he is with my NECA RoboCop figure. Right here. Now, what blows this away, this figure, now the old NECA figure may have a bit more darkening and shading and more detail and wash on it, but at the same token, it doesn't have the maneuverability of the Hagane Works version. Seems like it's a tad bit taller, but that's because, it's a tad bit taller. I would say like not even a quarter of an inch, it's a tiny bit taller. And some of the accessory, the gun is much bigger, but this figure is beautiful. Here he is with regular RoboCop from NECA. Here he is with, let me be careful, with the RoboCop from RoboCop 3. We had the jetpack and stuff like that. Now this one is still the most prettiest one I think that NECA made right here, but I still like this one. This one is absolutely beautiful. Oh, sorry. Here he is with, oh man, you know who I had to bring out, right? Hopefully the camera can catch all of them. Let me bring them down a bit. Let me see if I can bring them down a bit. Oh, fuck. Here he is with Big Daddy, Grumpy Big Daddy, ED-209, or Ed-209, since some of y'all want to kill me when I call him ED-209. Yes, I do like calling him ED-209, sorry.
It's no news.
And I mean, like, you know, this is just beautiful. This is beautiful. He scales very well with Ed-209, as you can see. And again, the feel of this figure and the beauty of the aesthetics of this figure are absolutely amazing. I have another RoboCop here somewhere. I don't know where I put him. Yeah, there he is with Ed-209. Let's bring him out of here. Oh, get this big boy out of here. All right. Here he is with NECA's, and yeah, I'm a big RoboCop fan. Here he is with NECA's battle damaged RoboCop. And this one, he's more chunkier and more solid than the NECA one. They're both beautiful figures. They're both beautiful figures. But I would actually, now that I'm seeing this up close and in comparison with my NECA ones, the Hagane Works one blows it out of the water. As a matter of fact, now that I put his legs together, I would actually say he's the same size, I think he's the same size as the NECA version. Let me see. Yeah, it's still a tad bit shorter, but I mean, he has more weight and depth to him. He has more chunkiness to him than the NECA version. Don't get me wrong, the NECA version will always be my baby, but I mean, like, this is... it's no comparison. Well, it is in some aspects, because now as far as articulation, the Hagane Works one just blows it out the water. You understand? But as far as like detail, painting, wash, etc., etc., the NECA version gets it. But at the same token, it's only so much you can do with diecast metal. So I mean, like, these are beautiful. I am loving this right here. I am loving this RoboCop right here. I would definitely say pick this up if you're a RoboCop fan. And you know, it's not, the joints aren't on a butterfly or anything like that. And again, as I stated before, let me bring this a little bit closer. This is a beauty. I mean, an absolute beauty to behold. 7 inches of metal and plastic, good quality plastic, good quality metal, beautiful painting, no blemishes, no bleeding, no nothing. This is good. I'm loving the way they gave him nice big feet, as RoboCop should. And they gave him a toe pivot and everything like that. The pistons on the back are beautiful. This is just a beautiful figure. And again, as you can see, I switched out hands and stuff like that. You can switch out the faces and stuff like that, but I just didn't want to chance it. And yeah, he comes with a stand, a Cobra assault cannon, everything, man. This is just a beautiful figure. So I don't know what else to tell you, but then this right here makes me want to watch RoboCop. And of course, I've seen RoboCop. RoboCop is up there. The first RoboCop is up there with me the same way that Transformers the movie 1986 is. I've seen it well over 200 times. I just like it for what it was, what it is, the dark comedy, so on and so forth. So, I don't know what to tell you guys, but I hope I covered everything, and I hope you will go out and purchase this if you're a big RoboCop fan. And I'm thinking I'm going to make a deal with Kenny to purchase this guy, because I'm loving him, man. Because I didn't think I wanted him at first, but now that I pulled him out the package, that's the thing with a lot of these toys now. When you first purchase them, they look a little bit like, when you're first looking at them in the package, you'd be like, ugh. But then when you get them out and start posing them and you see all the maneuverability, it literally makes me, don't get me wrong, I still love the NECA ones, but this right here literally just blew me away. This is so beautiful, absolutely beautiful. This is, wow. And it's more sturdier than my NECA ones. And most NECA toys, that you gotta kind of like, man, be careful with. But this right here is a solid piece. I don't feel scared about moving it around, shaking it or anything like that when I pose it or anything like that. And again, as I showed you before, you got the nice little compartment right here that you can get the glook glook. When he does the thank you for your cooperation. And it opens easily. I'm just trying to be careful because I have heavy hands. And you can put the little gun in there and everything just like the movie. Thank you for your cooperation. Now, if they had like a little gimmick where you could spin the gun around, oh man, that would have been, man, listen. But yeah, ladies and gentlemen, I think I covered everything on this beautiful guy right here. It is absolutely amazing. Love the detail, love the articulation. I didn't think I would ever see an action figure, a RoboCop action figure with this much articulation and sturdiness, but it's beautiful. It's beautiful. So with that being said, that brings this review to a close. Be sure to like, comment, and subscribe, and share this video. And don't forget, and you know what to do. You know what to do when you buy a toy. What? Bust it open. He's a cop killer.
Murphy. It's you.
Shooting, son. What's your name?